Hello, my name is George Carter. I'm an assistant professor here at the Medical University of South Carolina. I've been on faculty for almost 2 years, and during that time I've been one of the providers in our Tele-ICU, something I'd like to tell you about because it's work that we're really proud of here at MUSC. The Tele-ICU is an initiative that we do in cooperation with our partners at Hicuity Health to provide care for patients in ICUs and community hospitals in smaller areas of the state of South Carolina, really throughout the country and the United States. To provide care for those patients who might not have access to board-certified critical care physicians 24/7, around the clock every day. Some of these hospitals have daytime intensivists, some of these hospitals have no intensivists, but in all cases, these are hospitals that are not large enough, that don't have enough ICU beds to be able to fully staff an around-the-clock intensivist, and we're going to use our services to extend what we have here to them so that they can provide high-value care. One of the things that I'd like to walk you through here is the system that we use, the technology setup that we have to enable us to do that. As you can see, there's a lot going on these screens, so we'll just walk through each part individually. The first screen that I'm going to start with is on the bottom left here. This is really the home page for all of the care we provide in the Tele-ICU. This is our e-care manager. So again, this is proprietary software that will incorporate all of these different hospitals that we work with, all of the charts, all of the electronic medical records, all the patient data that we have across dozens of hospitals, and we'll aggregate all of it into one place so that I have this at my fingertips. So I can go through, I can filter for particular hospitals, I can quickly find any particular patient in any particular bed, and I can see not just what we have here on the homepage, which is some things where it'll have alerts for what might be wrong with the patient, but I can also open up the patient in this spot, and it's going to pull in lots of data from their chart, not just about things like labs and their vital signs or their ventilator and how they're doing clinically, but it's also going to specifically focus on some of the things that are the most important to us in the Tele-ICU, which are ICU best practices. These are some of the core quality metrics that we're using to measure high-value care in the ICU, and it's one of the most important ways in which we can really improve the care that's being provided at these hospitals with our services. So as you can see, we pull this up, and we have all sorts of information about each individual patient at our fingertips, and it's very easy for us to flip back and forth. As I said, we work with our partners at Hicuity to cover all of these different hospitals. There's many different systems that they use. They're all on different electronic medical records, and being able to keep all of those things straight and being able to access them can be challenging. So we have a whole system that's set up for us to do that. We have here a Citrix where we can get in and we can access remotely all of the different medical record systems. Hicuity has also built for us a password manager so that we can go through and we can find our login credentials, again, for each of these systems that are set individually, so that I can very quickly pull up any information that I need to from those patients' charts. That's all in a system that we call our hub, and this is essentially a web page with a bunch of different functionalities and tools that we'll talk about, but one of the important ones that I'll also highlight here is something called our hub census, where just like in eCare, we can see a list of all the patients who are admitted to each one of our institutions, to see the patients in those beds, to see what's going on with them at a glance. And I also want to point out here that we have a system where we're able to triage these patients. There's a rudimentary AI system that Hicuity will use that will go through all of these charts, that will comb them, find information, and will assign each one of them to essentially a red light, yellow light, green light system, where the patients that are flagged as red are high acuity, they need closer monitoring, the patients that are intermediate are flagged in yellow, and then the lower acuity patients that are maybe less urgent are going to be flagged in green so that we can see very quickly what's going on with them, and that's here. As I mentioned, when we work with Hicuity, we're working with other doctors, not just here in South Carolina in our Charleston Center, but other doctors throughout the United States. And we actually have international physicians who partner with us as well. And so at a glance, we have our Hub TV system where we're able to see the availability of everybody who's currently assigned on a shift. We can see where they're physically located. So we have Maryland, North Carolina, Tennessee, New York, and Missouri, all of which represented on shift today. We can see where they are, what their contact information is, and if anybody's busy or unavailable. So if somebody's in a video call with a patient or on the phone with a nurse and something comes up that would ordinarily be their responsibility, we have a buddy system where somebody else can jump in and take care of that for them so that we're all able to cover for one another and make sure care happens in a timely fashion. As you can see here along the bottom of the screen, I have access to lots of electronic medical records. These are two examples of completely different institutions on completely different systems. So I have one Epic system, one Meditech system, and even though they don't talk to each other because they're different hospitals, I'm able to pull all of them up simultaneously if I need to so that I can take care of patients, again, at multiple sites, multiple locations, multiple different states, but I can do all of it right here from the same workstation. As we have access to their charts, I don't just have access to things like lab results and vital signs and the notes that are written, but I can also pull up results like chest x-rays. So if something happens in the middle of the night, I'm able to actually pull up their imaging system as well, find out exactly what's going on with that patient. I'm not having to wait for something like a radiologist to get back to me about what they see. We can intervene in real time. I also, on the top left, you can see, have access to the waveforms from the monitors in those rooms so that I can see exactly what a monitor in the room is going to show. We can see the patient's rhythm, their blood pressure, all of the different vitals and real-time information that's necessary for us to know exactly what's going on in that room. And I can pull that up for any hospital that we cover and see exactly what's happening. So if there's a particular patient that I need to keep an eye on or that we're worried about, I can have their information up and see exactly what's going on at all times. We also, as I said, we have a large team that we're taking care of. We need to coordinate our care. We always have a Teams window open. We'll have a group chat going so that we can make sure that everyone's able to communicate with one another and to, again, be coordinated and make sure nothing's slipping through the cracks and we're managing care in a timely fashion. Speaking of the care that we provide, there's really three things that we do for all of these hospitals, different sort of levels of intervention or service that we provide. I'll go through an ascending order of immediacy as to what we do. So the first and most basic, but not unimportant thing that we do is admissions. Every patient that's admitted to an ICU bed in one of our partner hospitals is going to have their chart reviewed by one of our high acuity physicians. They're gonna go through, they're gonna see everything that's going on with the patient. They'll video in and speak with the patient. They'll speak to the nurse. They'll see what the team at the bedside has been doing in terms of their plan. They'll make sure there's nothing that needs to be adjusted. And then we also review every one of those patients for the quality control metrics that we talked about. Make sure they have things like DVT prophylaxis. Make sure they have things like appropriate ventilator settings to make sure that we're not causing any harm. And we'll go through, we'll leave a note in the chart so that that's all accessible for the team at the bedside, put any orders in that need to be done. Every one of those admissions will populate on our admissions board so that we know when it comes up and we know if it's our responsibility, we'll get those taken care of in a timely fashion. More urgent, although not an emergency, is an intervention, what we call those. So that's when there's something that's needed from the bedside team. The team at the bedside, the nurse will call in. They'll either speak to one of our triage nurses that we have with high acuity. They'll leave a voicemail for the doctors. And we're able to find out what it is that they need. You know, the patient has a headache and needs a medication. The patient's blood pressure is dropping. It's not to the point where it's an emergency yet, but we need to make some sort of intervention to keep it from getting worse. They can call in, give us the information that we need so that we can fulfill that request, get back to them, call them, put orders in the chart, whatever is needed to be done to close that loop. The most emergent thing that we will take care of is something that we call an e-alert. This is the big red panic button on the wall of every room that is in one of our partner institutions. So if something's going on, a patient codes or a patient's about to code, something's happening that's emergent and they need help right that minute, they hit the big red panic button on the wall, an overhead alert tone will sound, and the team's gonna be alerted directly that they need to intervene. And at that point, they're able to video directly into that room. We can respond in less than a minute and be there much faster than even a bedside team can. All of these services that we're providing, we're providing not as the primary caregivers in this situation. So we're not the only doctors taking care of these patients in the hospital. We're always partnering with a team who's at the bedside. There's always bedside physicians who are available, who are hands-on taking care of those patients, and we're providing consultative or backup services, providing cross-coverage services, and making sure that they're providing the highest quality care available to them so that we can extend that. You can see here that our census, when we look at our status board, right now there's about 650 patients that we're covering across the country. During the daytime, there's four physicians on. At night, we typically will have 6 to 8 physicians. One of the most important capabilities that we have in the Tele-ICU is two-way video communication that's installed in every ICU room in all of our partner hospitals. Again, this technology allows us to virtually project ourselves into the room to see what's going on at the bedside, to be able to provide feedback in real time, to speak to the patients, to speak to the nurses, to speak to the staff, to speak to the bedside physicians who are in the room, and to be able to intervene in real time. Whenever something comes up that's going to need that close personal attention, whether it's a new admission that needs to be evaluated or the nurses have hit that e-alert button and I need to get in emergently, all I have to do is navigate to my EK manager, which, as I mentioned, is sort of the home screen for all the care that we provide. I'm going to navigate to whichever hospital's involved, navigate to the bed that's involved, and all I have to do is hit the video icon and it's going to pull up a video screen. On this video screen, I'm immediately looking at what's going on in the room. I can hear what's going on in the room through our headset that we have set up. They're able to hear me through the microphone that we have, so there's two-way communication. And then we also have the opportunity to send them video so that they can see me from the other end, And I can also control the camera from my end of the connection. So these cameras are movable in 360 degrees. I can look anywhere in the room. So if there's a family member standing in the corner that I need to speak to, I can navigate the camera and talk to them. If I need to look at the patient to talk to them, I can do that. If I need to look at any of the hardware that's in the room, I can also see the ventilator, I can see the IV pumps, I can see any of the machinery, I can see their monitor in the room. I also have the capability to zoom in. So in this room, if I click, it'll automatically focus on that particular area of the screen, which makes it very quick to navigate between different pieces of equipment. And then I'm able to zoom, and these are very high resolution, high fidelity cameras, so that in addition to getting that high level view of the whole room, I can zoom in and I can read exactly what's going on any individual screen in the room, piece of equipment in the room. As you can see, as I zoom in on this computer screen, you're able to very easily read what it says. And as you can imagine, if this was a room that had a ventilator in it, I can zoom in, I can see exactly what the ventilator waveforms look like, I can see what the ventilator settings are, I can read off what's happening with an IV drip to see exactly how much medicine's being administered, I can see the patient's monitor just like I can replicate it in the room for me, I can see what's going on in the room there. And this gives us the ability to, again, virtually project ourselves to be as if we were at the bedside to be able to give that level of care and that level of attention to detail. The Tele-ICU is an impactful program that has allowed partner hospitals across South Carolina to see demonstrable improvement in clinical and financial outcomes. Our MUSC Health and Hicuity Health intensivists will continue to monitor ICU patients in order to reduce average patient length of stay and save more lives.